So now that we've added search capabilities to our API, let's go ahead and test them in the browser. Minimize Atom and load up the Git Bash window that's connected to our Vagrant server. Make sure that the development server is still running. And then load up Chrome, and on our API page, click on the root of our user profile list. This shows us a list of the user profiles that are in the system. We're going to create a new user to test the search capability. I'm going to create a user profile for my wife and business partner, Brooke. So I'm going to add the email address, brooke@londonappdeveloper.com. In the name, I'm going to type her name, which is Brooke Rutherford. And in the password, I'm going to give it the same password that I use of awesome1. Hit enter to create the new user account. You can see that there's now a user account with the ID 5 that has the email address brooke@londonappdeveloper.com. So let's use the filter capability to search for this account. Go back to the user profile list and notice that we have this new option up here called filters. This is because we've added the filter backend to our API. So it knows that we can filter by the name and email fields. So click on the filter button and we'll search for the name Brooke. Enter the name and hit search, and you see that it returns this user account that we just created. Also notice that it added this search parameter up here in the URL. So when you're using the API from a client application, like a mobile app or website, this is how you would use the search feature. Because the application isn't going to be clicking around on this nice looking web page, it needs to add the filter parameters up here in the URL. These are called get parameters. So it adds a get parameter called search, and it adds the search phrase to that parameter. So we're searching for Brooke, and it's looking for any profile that has the name Brooke in the email or the user, or the email or the username. Next, I'm going to search for my other account. I'm just going to type in the word Mark and hit enter or hit search, and you see it returns my user account. Okay, so it looks like the search function is working properly on our API. Let's commit our changes to Git. Close Chrome or minimize Chrome and load up the Git Bash window that is working on our local machine, so the one that we're using for Git. Type git add dot to add any new files that may have been created. Hit enter, and then type git commit hyphen am. We'll add the message added search function to user profiles API. Close that off and hit enter to commit. Okay, so that's how we test our search functionality. Thank you for watching, and I'll see you in the next lesson.